Hey everybody, welcome to World of Horror, the full release, well no, it says it's still a free release, the latest version that has, it's from Alpha, the beta release, that's what it's called, of World of Horror. Welcome, we played this before, it was really cool, and now it's way more fleshed out. It's, for those of you who are new, this is a game where you encounter otherworldly things and try to battle them and save the world as a random Japanese person, or not a random a Japanese person who is trying to protect the world from various otherworldly horrors. Would you like to customize your next playthrough's look? There's 2-bit? Oh, there's 2-bit style now instead of 1-bit. Interesting. Sure, we'll do 2-bit. But otherwise, different palettes. Okay, no, let's not randomize. Let's keep things normal. But the 2-bit gives extra shading, so that's cool. If that's your first time playing World of Horror, it's recommended that you start with the spine-chilling story of School Scissors, with the option before trying more complex playthroughs. Okay, so these are the difficulty settings. So yeah, we'll do the spine-chilling story of School Scissors. So, yeah, I guess there's gonna be some sort of mystery in a school. Something strange is happening in the city of Shikawa, Japan in 1980X. Oh, that's why it's like the old Macintosh style, 1980s style of gameplay, or window like layout, which is kind of cool. Rogue figures can be seen gathering in the woods at night. People are going missing. Disgusting creatures are terrorizing the seaside. The rapid technological progress of the modern era brings comfort, but also unknown threats. Old gods, malicious eldritch beings who ruled the Earth eons ago, are awakening as reality starts to crumble. Armed with clues, spells, and your dwindling sanity, you'll investigate mysteries across the city and in realms beyond. An old train slows down as it stops at its last station. The end of the world is at hand, and you finally arrive in the doomed town. Alright. So, I guess it gave me a character by default. I really like the music. It's like almost like Konami style, like action music. Right, there was a Doom percentage. If Doom reached 100%, that was bad news. And I think Doom is approaching continuously. So we gotta do things quickly, but not too quickly, because take enough time to prepare, but not too much time that we're too slow and there's too much Doom, as it were. So there's a time element. You've been following the weird cult for weeks now, barely surviving the encounter with the skin hag at the nursery and its race against time. It's a race against time, and you can't rest until until this town is safe. Okay, that's... sure. Start the mystery. I guess maybe that's the creature that's... is involved in the city, or in the scissors mystery. Okay, spine-chilling story of School Scissors. Another boy from your school has disappeared. Rumor has it, a terrible woman has returned from the grave. A woman with the widest smile and the sharpest scissors. Yeah, the creator of this game has really stepped up their music game a notch, I gotta say. The music is kicking. Alright. Your missing friend left you a notebook. If the rumors are true, to stop the tall woman with scissors, you'll need to perform a ritual to force her to the material... force her material form to appear in our dimension. Okay? Interdimensional creatures. I mean, that's very H.P. Lovecraft. According to... accomplishing this first requires the drawing of an eldritch sigil, and then lighting of holy candles. You can only hope your friend has left them somewhere around the school. Because if not, we're screwed! Okay. So everything happens in the school today. Alright, I got my friend's diary. You start... Or wait. What? You retrieved an item from storage. Okay, cool. Now we're reading it. Okay. On the 14th. Maru is acting strange. I need to talk to her after class. I hope she doesn't attempt the ritual herself. I've hidden the candles in one of the classrooms. Tomorrow I will perform the ritual. The sigil can weaken the demon for a while. Careful with the lines. Now they do look a little tricky. It's two triangles inside each other. Three triangles? Wait. There's one triangle, another triangle, and another third weird-shaped triangle. Is it three triangles? I'm a little confused. Oh wait, no, there's some lines here, and the dot. Okay. Well, yeah. Careful with that one. It's tricky. And then something that's like lined out. Something strange. A strange call. Strange tall woman has been following me all day. I should hurry up. Okay. I was able to read that. Cool. Alright. So I guess let's explore the school and hope we don't get stabbed. Oh, that's cute. Alright. So, like, chibi version of me is walking around. Important messages will appear here. Whoa! Whoa! Okay, that was a little bit jump scary. You feel like something horrible is happening with the school. You must hurry and find those items. Okay, so. I guess was that the lady's face at the window? Cool. I can't perform the ritual yet, although that's an option. I guess I just keep clicking explore school. This is a little different from what I remember. This game has changed. You carefully enter the biology classroom. The room seems... This feels a bit more linear than I remember, but it's the tutorial mission, so... The room seemed empty at first, until you switched the lights on. You gasp in horror. Lying in a pool of blood is one of your teachers with a fruit knife in their hand. There's a jar of formaldehyde on the nearest table, mesmerized by the spiral pattern on the sea creature's skin. You step over the dead body and come closer. And then the voices start. I mean, I'm mesmerized by a sea creature. Whoa! The forgotten specimen. It's mesmerizing me. Alright, so we're in combat with the forgotten specimen. Fill the combat sequence, white bar, with moves, and click launch sequence to attack your enemy. This is different. This is cool. Alright. They got, like, the combat music going on. Alright, so he has 15 health damage. Each sequence, enemies will perform an attack draining your stamina, your reason, stamina, or all. So he's gonna hit my reason. He's attacking my mind and has 20 power. This stat defines your chance to successfully attack the enemy. The higher power, the harder it will be. Currently, your chance to hit is lowered by 10% because it's powerful. Okay? And so, like, spiritual actions. Lower multiple means that actions will take less time. So what spiritual actions can I take? I can clap. Okay? Most combat rituals are a combination of 5 bows. Oh, this is interesting. Most combat rituals are a combination of 5 bows and claps. Even if you don't get it right, you'll be provided with a hint. Oh, alright. Japanese spiritual magic includes lots of politeness. You know, a nice clap, a few bows, you'll be fine. Clap, bow, and pray. Alright. Regain 1 stamina cost 2 reason. Should I start bowing and clapping at it, or should I actually, like, physically hit it? The question of the day. It's a training fight. Okay, I'm gonna start. Oh, hello! Hello, hello, forgotten specimen. I will bow to you. First, we start with a bow. Alright. Then a clap. Then a bow. 2 claps. Bow, clap, bow, clap, clap. Wait. Oh, no. It's five? Three claps. No. The final bow. Wait, cancel. Wait, let's clear this. Okay. Bow, clap, bow, clap, clap, bow. Because we gotta end with a bow. Launch sequence! Nothing happens. You think you got one ritual moves right. I got something. I did something right there. All right, cool. Will this ritual be useful for other things?
Yeah, I found my dead teacher, and I was dealing with this forgotten specimen, so I bowed and clapped it repeatedly.
Okay, so this is like Mastermind or whatever that game. I got one move right. Too bad. Okay, well, fine. I'm just gonna bow like crazy. Start bowing faster. Launch sequence. Bow, 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 bow. Nothing happens. You got four ritual moves right. Four of the ritual moves are bow. Okay. So then that means it's one clap. Okay, so I'm gonna go bow, bow, clap. Bow, bow, bow. Got three rituals right. Is it attacking me? Is it my... Oh yeah, it's draining my reason every turn. My mind is turning to jelly with all the clapping and bowing. Okay, wait, I got three moves right. Why was that? Is it the... Oh, it's the positioning of them. Okay, so... I just need to turn one into a clap, so I got two wrong when I put it in the middle. So the clap does not go in the middle. Okay, clap. I guess do I just keep... What's the fastest way to figure... I forget, there was like a strategy in Mastermind games, but I forget what it is, so I'm just gonna keep doing this. Well, what if I did all claps? That wouldn't tell me much. Oh, you can pray, though, instead. Okay, well, I can use that. Okay, I'm gonna clap. And then I can... Oh, but that's gonna use up my reason. To get my stamina back. That's not what I want to do. I don't want to pray right now. I was hoping that I got my reason back. You can't do that. Okay, sick. Okay, so... Okay, so start with a clap, and then just start bowing like crazy. Launch sequence. Nothing happened. This ritual only works on ghost enemies. Okay, so... Just, if you ever, guys, if you ever run into a ghost, clap and then just start bowing like crazy. Hello! That is what you do at a shrine! Oh, that's a Japanese shrine thing! Okay, cool. If you know about Japanese culture. Interesting. Okay, that's not gonna help me right now, but let's remember that. If I can remember that. Clap, bow, 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 bow. Alright, ghosts. I learned how to fight ghosts this day. But I'm just gonna have to beat the crap out of this. I don't have weapons. Prepare your attack. Next hit is attack is guaranteed to hit. Attack boost. Your next attack has an additional 10% chance hit. This affects stacks. Just kick him. Just kick it. Just kick the jar repeatedly. Oh, I'll have extra time. Okay. I guess. Do like three attack boosts and then just kick the jar repeatedly. Oh, kick costs 55. Okay, so boost, kick a kick. Launch sequence. just kick the jar! Kick it repeatedly! Kick, kick, kick. Boost, kick. Point, boost. Kick, boost, kick, boost, kick. Launch sequence. Okay, you've defeated the forgotten specimen by kicking it. There was a jar on the desk and I just kicked it repeatedly. Oh. And now I have won. And I found the lump of flesh, and then I pulled it out of the jar. Does our character, does his eyes look very worn? It looks like our poor guy has stayed up like 100 nights. He's very tired. He's getting a little... Oh, and we found the blessed chalk. You found an initial page from your friend's diary. It seems... No, that the blessed chalk was on the roof. Can we choose where we go? Peek outside, explore school. Do I want to peek outside? I feel like if I peek outside, I'm just going to get... Like, that lady's going to be at the window, and I'm going to get scared. I'm scared enough as it is. I might fail the tutorial mission, you guys. But I learned at the ghost ritual. On the roof, you find the girl your friend was talking about. In one hand, she holds a bag. In the other, a pair of bloody scissors. Oh no, it's the scissor lady! And boy, does she have extra cuts. It's like her mouth has been scissored open, and same with her eyes. She just has a lot of extra space in all her holes. Oh dear, okay, so, she does 1 damage to everything. She has 12 hit points and is 15 power. I don't think Maru the Scissor Lady is a ghost, so I don't think clapping and bowing like crazy is gonna save us right now. Can I run away? Is that an option I can do, or do I just... Don't make me kick you! Because it's not as effective as scissors. Do I have... Look for an improvised weapon. Pick up a random improvised weapon. Huh. You don't say. Combat skill. Lowers your experience by 5 and raises your chance to hit by 10 for the rest of this encounter. One time use only. Need stamina or reason lower than 3. Oh. When you're low, should I look for a weapon? Try to get a weapon. And then, like... Okay, defensive actions. Dodge. Regain 1 reason for 2 stamina. If I could meditate if I really need my reason back. I might need to meditate. Just find an improvised weapon and then dodge. Oh, I need 110 seconds for that. Well, that's not useful. Brace for impact. Strength-based. I kind of want to find a weapon. But if I'm looking for a weapon, then what? There's no point in bowing at her now. Find a weapon and then kick her in the meantime. Okay, fine. Clear sequence. Find an improvised weapon. Boost your attack and then kick her. Oh, I have time for 2 boosts. They cost 10. Okay, I need to do my math properly. Alright. Find a weapon. Boost. Okay. Alright. Launch sequence. I found a branch! You may have scissors. She bashed me with a bag. Okay, well, that's nice. You may have a bag and or scissors, lady, but I've got a branch. Branch. Pass to equip. Damage plus 3, speed 90. So, can I put it on? Weapon, no weapon. Branch. A, B, equip. All right. Yeah! Look at that. That branch just, like, click into place like it's a weapon. Wait, lump of flesh. Plus 5 stamina. Flip this card. Eldritch medicine. I could eat the lump of flesh. Oh, there's this undulating lump of flesh I could eat. That would be a good idea. I mean, I am kind of hungry. Maybe later. Okay, so now, instead of kicking, I can feed her with a branch. It's got less chance to hit. Does 3 damage. Takes 90 time. Is that better? Strong attack. 4 damage. 135 time. 65% chance. Well, okay, so this is... Kicking is still better. Is it because my strength sucks? I got a branch, but I think kicking is still better, isn't it? Hang on, it says 90 time. But it says 69 when I put it in. Hang on. I'm a little confused. Okay, so it doesn't take as much as it says. Okay. Well, yeah, we gotta use the branch, because it does it in increments of 69. Alright, branch, kick. All right, my reason. I'm starting to lose reason. Branch, branch, kick. All right, we have defeated Maru by smacking with a branch repeatedly. You found the blessed chalk, which you can use to draw the sigil in your ritual. You copy the sigil as best you can on the blackboard. Hopefully, it'll be enough. Oh. Okay. Wait, wait, wait. Well, first, blessed chalk found, holy candles not found. So I still need to get the holy candles, but I'll need to redraw this sigil. This sigil doesn't look right. Gotta adjust them triangles a bit. What was the design? It was triangles. Was it this? Wait, Prince Irie. One triangle going up, one triangle going right, one triangle going left. Oh, but these two kind of match up. Does that look right? That does look right, doesn't it? Just want to make sure. Oh, but then you can put on additional lineage. Okay, that's important. Yeah, there's like a line over there on the left side, but it looks a little different. Ah, is that it? Is that it? No, don't eat the lump of flesh. Hang on, we'll... Yeah, there's a circle, there's a line, there's a thing. Okay, this is basically it, right? That looks a little tiny bit different, but it just looks... Yeah, that's it. That's the one. That's the one. Okay, can I meditate spells? Rituals. Not active rituals. What does that mean? Cauterize. +2 stamina. One time only. Okay. I was kind of hoping I could meditate out here and trade stamina for a reason, but... Guess we'll just do that in combat? No, the ritual's not ready. Whoops, wrong button. Glad it doesn't force me to do that. Alright, away we go. You run into an anatomy class. You hear the faint sound while walking outside the anatomy, or the biology classroom. Inside is an old anatomy model with its heart still beating. And the sight makes you sick. Resolve events. Alright. Continue to explore the school. A tall woman with an unsettling face and twitching lip stops you. I'll be your new biology teacher. Could you help me move some stuff into my new office? No! She suddenly grabs your hand. Oh, I insist. -2 reason. You've run into an... Okay. Guess I'm forced to help her. And I also lost 2 reason. Luck check failure. The creepy substitute teacher hands you dusty old biological specimen. The rancid jar of formalin almost makes you drop the jar. Should fetuses have so many legs? -2 stamina. Resolve this event. Okay. Apparently that wasn't the tall scissor lady. But, like... Still, like, well, I guess it's a ghost possessing people? My reason is down to 3, and I'm a bit worried about that. You found the holy candles in your friend's backpack. You lit them as instructed in the notebook. Everything is ready for the ritual. Then let's perform the ritual! Wait. What's that? You take a step back as the writhing amorphous mass slowly takes shape. Soon it becomes a tall, woman-like creature with 3 faces, all connected by a wide smile. Now's your chance to fight and defeat this horror. It's also your only chance. Hey, lady, he got more faces than I expected. Twisting and twitching, the demon woman enters the classroom, cackling menacingly. Am I beautiful? Am I? +2 damage to all stats. And I only got 3 reason. And I'm thinking it's game over when I reach 0 reason, if I recall correctly, which is real bad. You wouldn't happen to be a ghost, would you? She might be a ghost. Alright, first things first. Okay, I'm gonna trade. No, wrong. Clear. Sorry. Not prey. praise the wrong decision. What was it? Desperate struggle. Doubles all damage dealt this turn. Not yet. Do I still have my branch from last time? By the way? I do. Well, that's cool. I got a branch. Don't make me use it. Wait, where's the thinking where I could trade defensive? Brace for impact. Meditate. That's what I need to do. Hang on! You may have scissors. I'm just going to meditate on this. All right, she's got scissors. So, okay, two stamina for one reason. How many do I need? 2, 4 Yeah, I'm going to trade 4 for 2 That'll get me through this turn. Then what next? I guess I'll dodge. And maybe I won't get hit. And then I'll, what else can I do this turn? I guess there isn't much else I can do this turn then. Well, I can try bowing early, but I don't think that'll help. The scissor woman raises her scissors, so she didn't hit me yet. Or no, she did. Oh, my lead, right, well, my reason is down. Oh, oh, look at my body. I'm all covered in cuts now. I'm gonna try the ghost ritual. I think I might regret this. Clap. Bow, 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 bow. You're a ghost, right? Please be a ghost. It was a ghost! Frozen in fear, you watch as she gets closer. Her sharp scissors are slowly cutting through your cheeks as she asks you, am I, or did she kill me? Am I beautiful? You perished. Oh, okay. I thought I didn't. I thought she was a ghost and she did more than 2 points of damage, or does casting a ritual like that cost my reason? I guess maybe launching rituals cost my final reason. I think I went crazy. You perished. By the scissor woman. Okay, well, in this run, you didn't complete a mystery, you saw 4 new events, 3 new enemies, didn't lock any achievements. Fun. Let's try again. Alright, so, I thought normally we got to, like, choose your character, but I guess that's, like, the old version of this game, or there's particular stories that are, you have to choose your, I guess there's particular scenarios where you are stuck with a particular character, and then maybe other scenarios where you get to choose. So who is our character exactly, by the way? What is your name? Was it in the main screen? Did I not see it? Alright, well let's try this again. Okay, explore the school. We know the drill. Oh, different things are happening. Impossible angles seemingly moving lines make your head spin. Stare in disbelief or needs an ally? I guess stare in disbelief. Charisma check, how is this possible? Alright, I only lost one reason. Do I need to read the friend's diary? I'm gonna do it just in case. Inspect. Other pages seem to be irrelevant to the case. Okay, cool. I didn't actually do that last time. Let's see what other events happen. Alright. You've encountered park guests. And that's this one that, like, is a bit of a jump scare here, right? Yeah. Okay. Let's peek outside this time. To open the door, click on the handle and drag the mouse with the button pressed. Oh, it's tactile. Oh, you should... You open it and there's a monster outside, then you immediately shut it. You shouldn't risk that again. Oh, but I do! Okay. Yep. Wow, there's all sorts of little scares. Something is wrong. Instead of the clear blue sky, you see a bloated corpse of a long-forgotten deity looming over the school's roof. The barrier between worlds is coming apart, so you must hurry or risk being noticed by whatever other eldritch horrors still lurk here. Try to sneak or just run? Or just sneak. Failure. You raise your head in time to see Hoth single eye staring down at you. You scream as your mind is flooded with forbidden knowledge, and your skin is etched with ancient runes and curses. Plus 20 experience, and a curse. Oh, wow. I got, like, runes on my right eye. Well, that's cool. And concerning. Cursed signs. Casting spells raises doom. That's cool. My eye is all... I've officially been upgraded into a main character of an anime. Alright, so I gotta change the lines a bit. That one? Yeah, that's the ticket. Okay, let's go to the rest of the school with my cool new tats. Alright, lose some stamina, cool. Sound of the scissors is getting louder, we must hurry. Needs an anatomy class perk. There was a perk for that? Huh. As you enter the school gym, you notice a strange black doll propped against the wall. Against your better judgment, you approach the doll. What you see makes you gasp in horror. I'm not getting a lot of choices here. It's just, like, things you need to have. The run or not run was the main choice before. It's more like what random throws at me. The doll isn't a doll. Your sudden movement causes tiny black spiders to flee a white, half-eaten corpse. That is really horrifying. That is truly horrifying. Oh, can I double-check the, we'll perform the ritual. Yeah, I guess I did it right. Okay, yeah. I wanted to make sure I had the symbols right. Is she gonna keep slapping on this as long as I wait? That's kind of freaky too. It's like she's slapping the whole screen. Alright, continue. Alright. I must have drawn it wrong. I drew it wrong? Well, I didn't know that was my one- whenever I got the chalk, it was my one chance to draw it, but apparently it was. Oh no! It's more powerful because I screwed up. That's not right. Oh no, that's not right at all. Oh no, god dang it. I messed it up. I thought I did, but I wanted to change it. Oh no, it's more horrific now. How am I supposed to- oh god, I'm gonna get killed. How am I supposed to beat it now? I know it's not a ghost. Right. Scissor Woman, horror. Okay, so it's a horror, not a ghost. Got it, it'll say it up there. Oh, you may have scissors, but I'm gonna kick you, apparently. Alright, so boost, kick, boost, kick, boost, kick. Well, let's see how this goes. First, kick, boost, kick, boost, kick. Is there a better way I can handle this? This isn't going well. I mean, I'm gonna win this, but I'm gonna be in bad shape. Yeah, I'm gonna win. You defeated the Scissor Woman by kicking her repeatedly, but you're barely alive. That's no good. The ancient horror lies dead on the classroom floor from your kicks. Slowly dissolving to nothingness, the only thing left of her are large scissors. You stare at them, unsure of what to feel. Something tells you you want to keep them. You need them. Very slowly, you pick up the scissors with your mouth widens in a smile. Spine-chilling story of school scissors. Ending B. The horror is over for now. That's not the only mystery plaguing this town. You must continue your investigation. Okay. So is that like a success or what? Like, that's a success. What did that earn me? Did that earn me something? Random, easy, normal, hard. Oh, there's difficulty. Interesting. Ah, customize a extracurricular activity. Customize a playthrough. Choose your own character, background, and other playthrough specifics. This is the story that I'm used to. Or that's the thing I'm used to. Okay, so World of Horror base game, yeah. World of Horror unlock pulse. Unlock while playing. Extended A, B, C. More students. Okay, cool. I want to do a random game. One last thing. A tall man left a suitcase for you this morning. He said you'll know the password. I wonder what that could mean. It's a seed. Okay. So let's put in my name. As much of it as we can. So this will be the Tiegon run through. Interesting. All right. And we'll try more various stories, but I want to try like selecting everything. Okay, so who are my characters? We've got Kiri Minami.
No.
Aiko Takahashi. Interesting, there's very basic voices. Haru. Ah, strength and cigarettes, that's right.
No.
Dexterity knowledge. Starts with one random spell. Mizumi starts with a random ally. Koji starts with a camera. What does a camera do? Perception minus dexterity starts with a camera. Starting with a random ally actually sounds the nicest, really. Alright, well, I guess we're doing the start where classic mode. Old gods are awakening? Oh, whoops, I guess I selected that. Select the old god. Now it's like a Pokemon screen. Select the old god and click again to confirm your choice. Atorasu, the spider god, I choose you! Or kind of, maybe not. I'm getting like a weird, like, Cthulhu meets Pokemon thing going on here. Ithotu, devouring fire! The towering eye. Oh, that's the thing that stared me down earlier. Gozio. The thing forsaken by God. Found a way to use mirrors to ensnare and teleport to its prey, straight through glass, and glimpses behind dual reflections are just the beginning of a real nightmare. That does sound freaky when you see mirror horror. Resisting doom. Resting increases doom penalty. Okay. Combat, stamina, penalties are doubled. Can't run from combat. Eternal web. I think the mirror horror sounds like the most horrific, but the spider god's pretty nasty too. Okay. Okay. I've got my new ally, Ryoko. Who's a park ranger and looks like a badass. Plus one to weapon damage. I know a faster way. Plus one to weapons damage. I guess we have to have a weapon first though. Oh, this is fun music too. My mailbox is empty. I'm at home. Take a bath, change clothes, watch TV. take a peek through your peephole. Start a new mystery. Weird. What's that? Just my imagination. Don't see anything weird out the peephole. Check again. Someone is in the shadow watching my door. Peek again. Peek at the peephole again. Peek at the peephole again. 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 Okay. I think this is all I'm gonna get. Change your clothes. Movie poster. Oh, don't look at the mirror. The monster's in the mirror. What outfits do I have? Yeah, put on your rebel outfit. Cool. You rebel. If you can tackle five you can tackle five mysteries in any order you want. But I gotta link a bunch of mysteries together. Okay, let's choose a mystery to investigate. Oh, I selected one at random. Whoops. There's a report of rancid ramen. Out of thin air, brand new ramen appears. Once people take a bite, they can't stop. Day and night, queue stretch outside the door. The shambling customers stuff themselves dish after dish while the blind owner sits silently behind the counter, grinning and polishing his gleaming knives. You're determined what discovers this to make this ramen so enticing. What is its true power? Dog meat? Human meat? The flesh of the gods themselves? Investigate this mystery. Can I not? Did I accidentally select on... Did I select it by accident? I guess I'm investigating ramen. Because I don't know how to click off. Whoops. I'm investigating ramen. Okay, cool. There was probably more interesting mysteries, but who cares? We love ramen here, and this old man is turning people into ramen zombies. And I am a girl who cares about ramen so much. Okay, so what am I gonna do? Okay, I'm currently at home. Travel to apartments, travel downtown, travel home. Dumpster dive. Discard two item cards to complete this quest. Oh, I have to discard two. Okay. Watching the local news, you spot a familiar street. It's a feature about the newest ramen shop. The food critic has a manic look as he describes the ramen. His description makes your stomach churn. Alright, well. Travel downtown. Police station. Shop for items. Do I have money for items? Where's my money? Old guy. Me. Oh, level up? Don't have enough experience. Oh, maybe I could have leveled up in the other one. I didn't know where the level up was. I don't think I have any money, do I? Is that my money? I don't know what my money is, honestly. Ah, police station. Manage combat encounters, experience into funds. Let's just investigate downtown. Oh, and it shows that I'm going with my friends, with my ally. I'm not alone. Once you enter the metro car, you notice an oddly shaped package on the seats opposite you. It's marked with your name. You reach for the package, but hesitate. An icy feeling settling into the pit of your stomach. Do I open the package or ignore it? Let's take a look at the package. Yes. Dexterity check failure. It's not until you've unwrapped it that you understand what it is. Shocked, you let it fall to the floor. From your bloodied hands. -2 reason. It was disgusting body parts. Somebody is trying to intimidate me with a bloody mess. I just started investigating the ramen shop and they're already on to me. That's not good. I just went outside, Jesus. Alright. Alarmed by the sound of glass breaking, you discover the corpse of a policeman lying in a pool of blood. Looks like someone or something tore out its throat. Oh, it's this event again! I'm gonna do the same thing I did last time. Steal his gun! Ah, He won't be needing it for sure, but you feel bad about stealing it from a corpse. -3 reason, but you get a gosh darn revolver. I will keep it. Oh, and there was that symbol in the background between the loading screens of the symbol that was in the previous encounter. Or the from the previous mystery. Okay, I could sell this for 5 funds. Sure, yen symbol. I don't see where in my interface the yen the funds are. Inspects. It's a new Nambu M60. Service revolver. Damage 3. Speed 80. Chance to hit 80. Damage when shot 9. Now, did I see... Okay, so I got the police revolver. Was there a number of bullets somewhere? Do I need bullets for this? Or was I thinking about something else? I have 5 bullets! And Ryoko knows how to use a gun, and she's gonna help me. Oh, I can talk to Ryoko! Ryoko looks at you and blushes. Good thing we're together in this, right? We sure are. You know how to use a gun, and we got one in 5 bullets. That's 5 solutions to our problem that are physical. Which is good. Alright. Maybe if I travel to the village, my reason will come back, because there's like a nice little shrine there. You had no idea that the funeral you've been invited to would end with the guests slashing their hands to feed the deceased with blood. You stay at the back, shocked by how grotesque it is. Suddenly, the guests turn their heads in your direction. It's your turn now. Okay, so, follow the awful tradition. Try to talk them out of this. Fight your way out, or needs folklore studies perk. I'm fighting my way out! Strength check success. The guests mean business. Breaking into a run, you smash into a mourner standing near the exit. Luckily, they don't chase you. New achievement unlocked, and +10 experience. To advance this mystery, investigate the circle location. As you progress, the rules and location may change. Ah, okay. I can store items from my neighbor. Okay, I thought the apartments was where I started, but... that would be, like, my home or something. You can't investigate your home. Okay, so... I got experience. I need 100 to level up. Okay, cool. Well, let's go! To the apartments! I was ready to shoot some guests, you know, I was ready to shoot the guests at the funeral. It's like, this is, we already have 1 funeral, let's not make another. I've got a gun and 5 bullets. Mr. Oh, your neighbor, or Mr. Ooh, I don't know, Mr. Ooh, your neighbor, is a horror manga artist. He's struggling to come up with a satisfying ending for his newest story. Or is it like Mr. Blank, all those is another word for blank kind of thing. Satisfying ending for his newest story. Share your experience. Let him come up with his own stuff. Well, what's that picture? Asking what's that picture sounds like I'm going to be horrified by something he drew, and that's... I'm not ready to get horrified. I'll share you my experience. Incredible! He shouts in excitement. How do you come up with this stuff? Sending the story will be a huge hit. He pays you in a token... pays you a token of appreciation. Yep, I gave experience for money, and I'm okay with that. I don't want to get scared by things. My mind is already ragging enough. And hey, now with this... Oh, okay, I have 6 money now. I have 6 money. Cool. So I could go buy a thing. Maybe. Cost doomed to enter the shop. But I can turn funds into items. Well, I'll wait a little bit longer then. Or what else? I feel like there's some new locations than there used to be. This is really cool. Alright, keep investigating the apartments. Encountered Wired Preacher. Excuse me, do you have a moment to talk about our real Lord and Savior? The day of reckoning is coming, says the voice on the other side of the line. You definitely don't like the way the man is on the other side of the line puts accent on real. Hello, are you still there? Hang up immediately. You put down the phone, a little shaken. Just how many people did that odd man call today? -1 reason. This game is just chipping away at my reason consistently. I'm physically fine. My mind is dying. When you stop by home to pick up your lunch, you find a pile of letters in your mailbox. Read the letters. Luck chance success. Plus two money. All right, because I won the lottery, apparently. Lucky you. All right, investigate downtown. Apparently I need to discard two items, but I don't have much. I only have this police revolver. I'd have to buy stuff to discard to complete this mini quest. Okay, well, investigating the shop. Petty thief. Walking through a crowded space, someone bumps into you and quickly apologizes, realize what's happening. Perception chance success. They stole your wallet. You quickly grab their arm and drop it before disappearing into the crowd. And they drop it before disappearing into the crowd. Aha! I was gonna get my money stolen! But instead I just got experience. Cool. Smell around the restaurant is overpowering. Grease, rot, and... is that blood you smell? These are story bits. I've been missing some of those. Little color texts. A woman bumps into you as she runs from a beauty parlor. Before you can say anything, you notice her face. She's carved out her own eyes! If I can't see it, she cries, it can't see me, right? I remember there was a comical monster in Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy that worked that way, so if that shows up, you're good. You shudder, seeing a faint vision of Gozio reflected in the beauty parlor's mirrors. Oh! That's because people are freaking out about the mirror demon. Okay. That is pretty messed up. Not worth ripping your own eyes out for, I guess. Don't think that'll protect you. One ramen, please. The owner's grin widens. Yes, ramen. Hearing footsteps, you turn around. Behind you stands a pretty woman in a sweater. Natural beauty, yes. This is exactly what I need. You shudder, seeing the weird woman reaching to her pockets, grabbing a nasty-looking knife. Pretty face. Mind if I borrow it? Oh, there's an aspiring model who has... her face is just barely attached. This lady is into putting faces on her face. And she's looking to update her face. You pulled back the gun's hammer, preparing for combat. You've got a knife. Oh, what was that quote from, what was it? The Untouchables, was it? I think it was. The Sean Connery quote. Their man pulls a knife. Your man pulls a gun. Your man winds up in the hospital. Their man winds up in the morgue. Don't bring a knife to a gunfight, lady. You just messed with the wrong person. Okay, so I got 5 bullets. So what I'm gonna do is fire weapon, perception based, yeah. Strong attack. Oh, strong attack, like, wait. I can smack her with the revolver as well? Oh, okay. So I could just pistol whip her and it's still a good weapon. That's pretty cool. Okay, prepare your attack. Next hit is guaranteed. Attack is guaranteed to hit. And then shoot her. That'll do 9 damage. She has 18 hit points. I just need to hit her twice. What if I just shot twice? Okay, I do have enough time to shoot twice, and I could just waste her. But it'd be a 50-50 shot, and she's gonna hit me for 2 stamina. I've got a lot of stamina. Or I could do prepare, and then shoot. Okay, if I did prepare and shoot, could I squeeze anything else in there? It only takes me 100 to dodge. Oh, there is a runaway option. Was that not there before? I don't think that was there before, was it? Could look for a weapon. How long would that take me? 120. Should I just try to shoot twice, or should I prepare and shoot? I guess prepare, shoots, and then pistol whipper for the fun of it. Does that work? Oh my god, when you shoot her or hurt her, her face comes off. And you see that she doesn't have a face on top of her face. She has legitimately replaced her face. And now this is a faceless lady I guess we can just pistol whip her at this point. Yeah, I only need to use one bullet, actually, honestly. That's a saving of one bullet, yeah. Just pistol whip her. Okay. You defeated the aspiring model and got lucky earrings! You weren't lucky for her. Equip plus two luck. Alright. I got lucky earrings, look at me. Cool. Alright, so... Yeah, just to confirm, I pistol whipped her, so... Like, I'll have... Where did I show my bullets? Yeah, four bullets. I still have four bullets. Just making sure. No rituals. 28 experience. With $8, what can I buy, I wonder? Oh, and it's a doggy shop. I could restock everything, but it costs 3% food. They've upgraded the doggy shop, so it's even cuter than before. Surprise discount item. Costs 1 funds. Oh, right, I can get some surprise discount items and then discard those if those aren't good and complete that mission. Okay, there's a steak knife. There's a compass. Plus 2 experience for each investigated location. Cigarettes. Plus 1 reason adds a new status. Addictive. There's woofing. Trinket. Food medicine. Use. Plus 1 dexterity until end of curate mystery. Energy drink. I'll take a compass, because that just costs 2. Oh, I only get 1 thing for the... Okay. Well, we'll use the compass. Oh, it goes in slot C? What about B? Oh, it's an accessory slot. What's slot B? I didn't get it. Jewelry? Got a nice pattern. Oh, I see. So, like, slot A and slot B are weapons, and slot C is, like, an accessory. Plus 2 luck or plus 2 experience for every single location I investigate? It's a good question. Okay, well, I might be discarding that. Let's go back to the dog shop. Okay, now there's a camera, plus 1 knowledge. Technology. Slot B. Okay, I see. It says it on top. Trinket slot C. Trinket food holy. Deals 4 damage to ghost type enemies. Well, I know the ghost ritual. So, I don't need that. Well, this is a B slot item. Costs 2 funds. Alright, yeah, give me the camera. Alright, we can put that in our B slot. Where's the slot C? So is this. I see. It says it up top there. Cool. Alright, and then shop one more time. We're up to 17, 21% doom. Random discount item, it's a bottle of milk. Plus 1 stamina to drink it. Yeah, drink that. I drink milk before I go on investigations. Oh, now I got an empty bottle. Okay, cool. Discard. Alright, so that's 1 thing discarded. I guess I'll discard the compass too. Cool. Dumpster dive, complete. You sneak into the alley in the dead of night. Gagging, you look inside the restaurant waste. It's a vile pulp. A few chunks of meat. Looks like promising samples, though. I got smelly meats. Food. Poison. Smells horrible. Inspect. Disgusting. Rancid meat of an unknown source. Okay. Yeah. I'm really wondering. I'm starting to think... Like, they're getting it from, like, corpses or something. From, like, a bad graveyard or something. I don't know. It's like they're feeding people zombie meat or something. It's making more zombies. Walking through the park, you find a little girl crying alone in her playground. When you ask what's wrong, she says that she can't find her mommy. Luckily, you spot the girl's address on a backpack lying nearby. Take her home, let the police handle it. Let's take her home. You offer to take her home, but when you get there, the terrified mother slams the door in your face. From behind the door, she starts screaming. She starts screaming to get the girl away. The little girl calmly tells you she can take it from here. So, the girl was some sort of horrible ghost or something? It's like a ghost child and like the mother was freaked out. All right. With a slick hand, you fill a vial with soup and walk out without tasting the weird dish. Target location, investigate lab. Oh, okay. We're taking the stuff to the lab. Get it analyzed. With the pulling of some delicate strings, you get the ramen into a lab. While handing over the gathered material, you hesitate. What should you send to the laboratory? Just the vial of ramen soup? Or the vial and the meat? Well, yeah, add the meat in there. You look at the charts and cannot believe your eyes. While the standard tests didn't indicate any weird, adding drops of human blood revealed something horrible. Whatever this thing was made of, it's alive! Beating a soft pulse against the glass, your friend leaves you with papers, muttering an excuse and preparing to flee town on the next train. Prepared for a fight, you march down to the restaurant. However, you find no eldritch horror to duel. Instead, you're shocked to find nothing but a gap in the streets. You ignore the distraught customers still lining up where they remember, still remember the entrance. Mystery solved. So, there was something, something alive in the meat. You are investigating missing girl? The old god stirs. The air feels heavy, fetid fumes making it hard to breathe. A feeling of paranoia and discomfort is almost palpable in the air. As doom progresses, old god's influence will slowly corrupt and change this calm seaside town. My home? I can go to the lighthouse? What's going on? Oh, I see. The ominous lighthouse has been closed down for longer than you remember. Enter lighthouse. Multiple padlocks prevent you from entering the building. You need 5 keys. Huh. Some sort of interesting mystery here. Some sort of bonus thing. Huh. Very intriguing. Inside your mailbox, you find a small key. What's it doing there? Take the key. Back in your home, you think of the next move. Get back to the town screen. Get the people. Let's have a bath. Cold water, extra reason gains. Warm water, small experience boosts. Hot water, extra stamina gains. What do I need? This requires empty bottle. If I had a bottle, what could I do? Bottle the bath water or something? Okay. Give me reason. Cool. Take a look through the peephole. Nothing weird going on. That's good. Let's go back to the town screen. Can we open up one of the locks on the lighthouse, I'm guessing? Okay, just checking. I was sent a small key. I thought it might have been for that. Like, as you complete challenges, you get more things. Alright, let's do one more mystery before I wrap things up. Alright, so, let's connect the dots. Ah, and there's different endings to discover of different cases. Interesting. So, the sorrowful saga of the Moonlight Sailors. Sailor Moon! Moonlight Sailors. Horrible history of household hell. Curious case of contagious coma. I think that was in the original game that we played. Eerie episode of evolving eels. Ooh, that does sound eerie. Let's do the eerie episode of evolving eels. That does sound freaky. Eels are creepy to begin with. While returning to your home, somebody suddenly bumps into you. Did you know? You turn around, and it's your friend living in the same apartment, Plex Kana. That weird dude is back. You know, the one who studies fish? You shrug, opening the door. Kana follows and immediately enters the kitchen. A while later, she returns with 2 cans of sodas. Aren't you curious, that weird fish guy? What weird fish he brings this time? She grins. Sure, I guess. To advance this mystery, investigate the circle location. I saw the creepy neighbor carrying some jars inside his apartment. I wonder what weird fish he did find this time. Okay, so Doom's at 19%. I see. Doom went down a little bit from solving the case. The music is cool. Safe. No modifiers to skill checks. Oh, threat level. I see. All right, let's investigate. Oh, and Kana's with me. Is she just for this one? Friendly neighbor, importance. Minus one damage for received during combat. Ready for adventure. Kind of looks at you waiting. Okay, cool. You find an envelope lying on your pillow, a pillow in your bedroom. Inside is cash and a note. Someone has been watching you. They wish you luck in your task and promise to meet you soon. Just how did this envelope end up in your bedroom? Plus two funds, minus one reason. Yeah, that's kind of freaky. I don't know, couldn't you have been cool about it? Not be a creep. Dude's working at school, right? We could break into his office. What, do you mean we shouldn't? It must be empty, because he just came back from his classes, and his classes begin next week. Ichthyology. Investigate the seaside location twice to complete this quest. Okay, so let's do the extra ichthyology thing. Let's investigate the seaside. It does take a little... Screw the school, let's go to the seaside! Dark forces scheme against you. You don't know who you can trust anymore. Curse! I got cursed! Just randomly. Wait, what was that curse? My curse is a stalker. Someone is following you. It's a curse of the minds. Well, okay then. I'm legitimately being stalked. Oh, you can go to the schoolyard here. Recruit allies, learn gossip. Library. Doom for spells. Interesting. There's additional things you can do. Hardware store. Cost Doom. Funds into items. There's all sorts of neat little new locations that you can do in places. Funds to items heal injuries at the hospital. Neighbor. Cost Doom to enter chance for an ally. That is interesting. They've added a lot of options to this game. Okay, let's investigate the school. You enter the art classroom. The room is cluttered with half-finished sculptures and bizarre masks hanging on the wall. One sculpture strikes you as eerily realistic. Check out the sculpture. Check out the masks. Ooh, check out the sculpture. The head of the sculpture looks so lifelike. You move closer and raise your hand nervously to touch it. It falls off. Prepare for combat. A headless person stumbles out of the sculpting classroom and reaches for your head. Headless mannequin. It's... Okay, power. So, like, yeah, my accuracy to hit... Chance to hit is lowered by 5. It does 1 damage to all. It has 25 health. Okay. So, I can just kind of, like, slap it with my police revolver repeatedly. It will take... 5 slaps. I can do 3. Cool combat music, by the way. Or, conversely, I could shoot it 3 times. My chance hit is 75% when shooting. Yeah, let's shoot it. So prepare, shoots, prepare, shoots. Launch sequence. Bam! Bam! Okay. Yes, fill up all holes. Blam, blam! Alright. I got cut with a knife. Doesn't feel good. And then I'll just slap it repeatedly with a revolver. Which has an 85% chance of succeeding. I'm clear. Okay, so... Attack boost. Slap. Slap, slap. Yeah. Got it! Alright, you defeated the headless mannequin. I knew that picking up the revolver was the right idea. Ooh, a policeman's revolver? Yes, please. It's worth the penalty and reason. Neighbor's office at school was empty. You did find a few jars filled with weird eel-like fish. Despite your protest, Kana decides to take one of the jars home. That is not a good idea, Kana. Have you ever seen an eel like it? This? It's so freaky. Don't you have a feeling it's watching us? Yes, I do. How can she sip her soda so calmly, staring at this creepy creature? I don't know, Kana. This thing is gonna escape and, like, attack you or take over your brain or something. I don't know. Want to go to the seaside? Okay, so I got 2 bullets remaining. Am I ready for a level up? Not quite yet. But soon. I can't wait to get a level. I forgot what level entailed, though. Right. So to the seaside. So the girls go to the seaside and everything's fine. Something pulls you toward the beach. A statuette half buried in the sand is calling you. You feel your hands shaking as you step closer. Take it home or ignore it. Take it home. The statuette is surprisingly heavier than it looks. Mesmerized, you take it home and wonder where to display it. It's a bad idea. You're going crazy and you can swear something is watching you from the sea. -1 reason. Son of a... I knew better. I mean, like, I just thought there might be a good side to it, but, like, it was calling me towards it. You gotta resist the evil, not embrace it. Now I got an evil statuette in my house. That's great. That's great. That's wonderful. And I got a stalker. This is what happens when you get into the Eldritch. You get a stalker, you get, like... You get into a lot of trouble. Alright, let's investigate our apartments. Not wanting to wait for an elevator, you decide to take the rarely used stairs. You suddenly trip, but grab the railing at the last second. When you get up to inspect what caused the trip, you freeze in terror. It is slowly standing up. The twisted corpse. I tripped on a corpse and it stood up. Okay, so this one does 1 damage to my reason. Don't like it, but it's not as bad as the thing we fought before. It has 15 hit points. It's a ghost enemy. Incorporeal. This attack can't hurt a ghost enemy. You don't say. Interesting, I've got new options. Leave an offering. Burn a material offering in an attempt to appease the ghosts, costing $1 and dealing 8 damage. Yes, I'm just going to burn money. Alright, no, I know the ritual. Okay, you clap, bow, 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 bow. Ha ha. Launch sequence. Ha ha. Alright. Nothing happens, but you think the ritual is too long to have an effect? Nothing happens, you think you got... Did I do too many bows? Wait, what? 5. Oh, I did too many, didn't I? Oh, because I was too fast, or wait. Clap. 1, 2, 3, 4. Should we clap 4? Oh, I had extra time. What am I thinking? Oh, no. There goes one of my reasons. Sever their ties to our world. Time to need 100. Will this work? Camera flash. Use your camera flash to temporarily blind the enemy. Let's try this sequence. Nothing happens. I'm screwing up? I thought I learned the ritual. I guess not. You think you got 2 ritual moves right? Aw, I thought I knew something for later. This is an issue. That's what this is. Alright, tell you what I'm gonna do. Can I run away from this? Ends the encounter for a doom penalty of 5% doom. This is like wearing on my reason. I'm thinking I might want to just run away. Like, that's a smart thing to do sometimes, is just run away from your problems. Or I could throw money at it. It'd take two money. Does this use up my police revolver? I hope not. Let's try sever the ties. It's ties of the world. Okay, that took it down to 11. Okay, then if I leave an offering, it'll be at 5 health. This is gonna be rough. I actually just ran away. Okay, so yeah, spend two turns doing that, and then give it an offering. There we go. And then buy it off with money. You burn the money! You defeat the twisted corpse. Resolve combat. Oh, that was rough. But I still have my police revolver. Ah. Ooh. 7 reason. My brains! Alright, I get 8 experience for defeating the twisted corpse. Just need a little bit more experience when I get a level up, so... Alright, just hold it together. Investigate the fire escape. As you prepare a bath, you think about all the possible leads so far. You're very tired. Maybe ice-cold water is a good idea. So wait, cold bath was my reason. Hot bath, stamina. Cold bath, reason, right? Strength check failure. Your body wasn't prepared for the cold bath, and you feel cold coming on. Aww, it was a strength check versus something else. Well, minus 2 stamina, but at least I kept my reason up. Kano was right. Someone tried to burn the papers. They must have been in a hurry because some of the papers look salvageable. Oh, I didn't read one of the flavor texts. You both return to your apartment and try to decipher the notes. New found item, burnt notes. Interesting. Legend from the blank prefecture, eels, tell of a small village of robbers who would kill all visitors and dump their corpse into a lake full of eels. So, yeah, corpse-eating eels. Just monster man-eating mutant eels that have evolved to eat people. That's so weird. Your neighbor was really into eels, it seems. Yeah! Bad monster eels. It's concerning. A woman jumps out of her apartment covered in gore. Between sobs, she tries to explain what happened. She was taking a shower when suddenly the shower had started spraying blood. A trail of blood leads into the dark apartments. Calm her down? Check the bathroom. Calm her down? Check the bathroom. Looks like I'm at 100 experience. Can I level up right here now? Level up! I'm gonna level up right now. You advanced to the next experience level. Choose a perk. Okay, so we got leadership. Quick thinking. Fame. Faster combat actions for each ally you have. Oh, reroll perks plus 4 doom. Interesting. Okay, so, wait. Leadership. Plus 1 charisma. Natural ability to guide others. Plus 1 dexterity. There's always a way. Faster combat actions for each ally you have. I've got 2 allies, so fame. I'm gonna go with fame. Okay. And then I can choose a stat. I get plus 1 of these stats, or plus 4 health or stamina or reason. It's kind of tempting to just go with plus 4 reason, honestly. But maybe I can get that back. I'm kind of lacking in strength, so I could compensate by getting some strength. Yeah, let's compensate. Let's quompensate and get some strength. Okay, cool. And, just tell her to calm down. Charisma chance success. The woman sniffs and smiles weakly. You feel like you prevented something awful. Plus 4 reason. Heck yeah, that's a level up's worth of reason. Woohoo! Alright. So that's good. There must be something more we can learn. I'll try to break into his apartment tomorrow morning. I wonder what he's hiding there. You shrug noncommittally. You just wish you could throw the damn jar in the trash. Alright, to the seaside! I guess we had to go to the seaside anyway, so I guess I went to the seaside a few times early in this adventure. But hey. Okay, so the town's docks are a mix of modern warehouses, small shops, and bars where the alternative crowd gathers. An ancient wooden temple occupies a small hill at the town center. Look for a warehouse job, try to recruit allies, pray at the temple. Recruit allies. Charisma chance success. It didn't take long to find someone to join you at the bar. You explain everything you know so far over a few drinks. I got our new friend Iwa, who it gives you +2 strength. Yeah. Alright. You were thinking about how stupid it is of Kana to try to break into your neighbor's apartments, and you go to sleep. You spend an entire day waiting for Kana. Where the hell is she? Oh no, we got Iwa, but we lost Kana, our friend. Oh no. Oh no. Well, let's investigate the school. We still have 3 people. Your reflection twists and shimmers when you're not looking at it directly. Gozio is getting closer. Curse. I have been branded by Gozio. Chance of raising Doom each investigation. Oh, that sucks. Doom's up at 28% already. Kana has been missing since yesterday. You decided to check out the neighbor's apartment yourself. Investigate the neighbor's apartment. You cautiously enter your neighbor's kitchen, and you are shocked to see countless jars filled with eels flailing around restlessly. Where is Kana? Uh-oh. Check the bathroom. Check the bedroom. Escape! Uh-oh. Uh-oh. I'm scared of the eels. I'm thinking she's in the bathroom in a bathtub full of eels. I'm gonna check the bathroom. Yep! A swollen body of your neighbor is rotting away in putrid, murky waters. Both his eyes are missing, with countless tiny blood trails leading from them in all directions, -1 reasoning and stamina. Cool. Cool. Wish I hadn't come in here. Check the bedroom. I found the neighbor. But when his eye bursted, I slipped on the blood and lost conscious. I'm afraid there's something in my eye now, too. Oh, no. Oh, no. We must go to the hospital. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, my God. Okay, so our options are... We saw what happened to the neighbor. He was dead. Something bursted out of his eyes. And now, Kana is looking at us. And we can either take her to the hospital, or we can stab her in the eye to save her life, costing us 3 reason. We're not gonna get her to the hospital in time. Like, and they won't want to know what to do. Oh, God, I've got to do it. I've got to stab out her eye, because only I can save her from the eel in her eyeball. Kana, this is going to suck. I'm going to have to puncture your eye right now. Oh, my God, it's making me do it. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Where is it? What do I puncture? Oh, my God, it's making me do it with the needle. Oh, my God, it's making me do it. Oh my God, this is terrible. Oh. Oh, oh no, eels. Eels are escaping everywhere. Oh no, eels are escaping from her eye. Oh no, wait, I was clicking like crazy. I was trying to stop him. Wake up, dude. You've been sleeping for over 3 hours. You groggily open your eyes to see your friend Kana. She's wearing an eye patch. Not so pretty anymore, huh? Couldn't exactly tell the doctors about the truth of what happened, but I'm pretty sure I won't be winking with my left eye anytime soon. But thank you for saving my life. Yeah! We did release a bunch of crazy eels, but we saved our friend's life, and now we've got a new friend. You still process the events of the previous night. Corpse-eating eels that lay eggs in eyes. Sitting with your friend Kana before your apartment building... You watch the police officers emptying your neighbor's place. Eerie episode of Evolving Eels, ending A. Alright, I think that was a good one. Rewards for solving this mystery. Knowledge is key. Through investigation, there's still hope. Minus 3 doom. Tireless. Plus 1 reason stamina. Time passes. Plus 1 day. Alright. The old god stirs. Contaminated water. There's something wrong with tap water. It's black, oily, and glistening, smelling like death. You hope this is just a temporary issue. Oh, okay, so rest is less effective. That's good. And you can't gain health between mystery. Your tap water is black and oily, making it useless to wash yourself. And now, notice the happy view of our town has gotten slightly more creepy. Okay. Inside your mailbox, you find a small key. What's it doing there? A, B, C, D, E. We got the E key. So does that mean if we go to the lighthouse? No, let's not choose a new mystery to investigate yet. Whoops, I keep hitting the wrong button. Town. So if we go to the lighthouse... Yeah, creepy music here. Unlock padlock C? You've already opened this padlock. Oh, I had C. I opened that padlock. Okay, cool. That's one down, and then I open padlock E. That's two down. We're gonna be getting in that lighthouse if we do good enough. Alright, well, I'm gonna save my progress and leave things here. You can check out... Oh, there's the light switch. Choose an action. I click the light switch. Weird. Nothing happens. I have a Cthulhu statue in my house. That's great. You know, the one from the beach. That's neat. That's neat that I have it, though. Move curtain. It's a nice day outside. There's a bunch of fun little things you can do between missions by clicking here. Open drawer. Close drawer. I wonder if anything extra can happen here. Let's take our bath. Use bottled water. Watch TV. Minor earthquake in seaside region has revealed an entrance to a partially flooded cave system. Local scientists have made at least some corridors maybe man-made. Well, anyways, I'm gonna leave things here. Thank you very much for watching this first episode of The World of Horror. I think it's a really cool game. It's got great music and a great style, and it's... I gotta say, like, once you've experienced all the events, it might not have, like, as much replay value as far as, like, the surprise factors and the spook factors concerned, but there's a lot of randomness that makes it cool and replayable, like... Kind of like Arkham Horror. It reminds me of the Arkham Horror board game, or those games a lot, where the Arkham Horror board game has, like, almost unlimited replayability, but reading the Mythos cards and encountering them for the first time, the encounters, and, like, reading the flavor text can be spooky and scary and interesting. And it's like that. Like, you'll never have the joy of encountering the spooky encounters for the first time, but you still get to experience the excitement and the difficulty of the game and its various game mechanics, and I think that's pretty cool. So, and it's just very random, and that's entertaining. Like, what random encounters will I deal with today? And what will the solutions of those things be? Like, what outcomes will I have when I choose to make certain choices? Because I don't think the outcomes are always the same, but... Anyways, make sure to like this video if you enjoyed it and want to see more of this game. And I will see more of you guys tomorrow or in the next video. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye, everybody! Watch out. Watch out for spooks in the nights or in the mirror. Be safe. Be safe. Eat well. Stay healthy. And watch out for spooks in the night or in the mirror, for the dark gods are watching. Good night, everybody.